My greenhouse got some Christmas presents. My husband got this one right here. It's very strange. It's gonna have to have a heavy pot at the bottom so it can stand up. Looks like an alien or something.
Look at the bucket.
It's got like warts on it or something.
All right.
Look at that. Very cute. Fixing to bloom. Another heat mat from a flowers I'm gonna be starting. Look at these. Adorable. Oh yeah. Cool. Oh, nope, too tall. It's like it's looking out into the garden. Look at it. It needs eyes or something. Weird. This dog's growling. Ceramic things we bought. Put my string of dolphins in there. Mm-hmm. Those are my husband's. He likes those. My husband made this little flower trellis. We got some of these little bamboo sticks. We wired them together, and I've rerouted this little guy on here. It's fixing to bloom again. And I've noticed after they bloom in the morning and they'll close up at night and fall off, and another bloom comes right behind it. Pretty neat. Got a little sprayer. Use that for my nematode spray or my little germinating seeds, which are doing really good. Got me another super sprouter ceiling heat mat, which makes a huge difference. As you can see, my zinnias come up really quickly on those, and I needed an extra one. Oh, the sun's in my face. Good afternoon. Hope you guys are having a good day. I've been out shopping. Oh my word. I don't know if I even want to talk about it. I don't think that I do. There are so many people out, and I had to go back out. I should have done a grocery pickup. I really should have. We'll just leave it at that. Okay, so down here in my greenhouse, and I'm gonna do some pruning. It got pretty warm in here today. The sun came out, so it's still 70 here now, and it's pretty chilly outside, so. So yeah, we finally saw the sun today, which was great. So that was good. I need to get my stove cleaned out because it's going to be cold again tonight, and I'm going to turn it on. And let's see what I got going on over here. Got some seedlings looking good. Still. I've got a little tray under them right now that they're kind of bottom watering up through here. So I wanted to show you guys this succulent right here. It's called Ruby Necklace, or String of Ruby Necklace, and it is just so cool. It's got like a purple stem, and it is fixing to bloom. Let's see if I can zero in on this little bloom here. And there'll be little yellow blooms. They'll be really pretty, especially up against the green and purple. So I can't wait till they open, but it looks like I got quite a few. I'll keep you guys updated on it. And this one is just growing every day. little bit more every day, actually a lot more every day. So that's going to be a really interesting little bloom there too. So we found another shelving system that we really like. It's 72 inches tall, so it'll be a lot taller, and it's also wider, so I can hang my light, because this one I've actually got like a little makeshift shelf going over here to extend it, because it's not quite as long, so I can put two little flats on it and fit my light. But this other little system it's wider. I think it's about the width of this light, maybe a little bit longer, and much taller, so I can put several lights in it for seed starting and just fill it up. It's definitely bigger, and it's also deeper too. So I think I'm gonna put that here at some point, and then we'll move this one. I may move this one in the center and put some of my other stuff that I've got sitting here on it. So that's something I'm looking at next for this area right here. Close this window. Cause temperatures are starting to drop. Now I'm gonna go down the chicken coop. My husband's already collected eggs, and he said that they were in the coop in a pile, not in the nesting box, but just in the back corner, kind of where Miss Queenie laid her eggs last time and sat on them. So I don't know if she's up to something. So I may go down there and check to see what's going on in there and give them some scratch, and then I'm headed inside. It's not super unusual that they're laying them in a different spot, because they either lay them in the run behind the straw, or then they go to the nesting box. Now they're back in the floor of the coop in a pile. They are super random. But they have been in a nesting box for a few days, so it's weird. I don't know. Surely nobody's going to go broody this time of year, but it's possible. Hello, Miss Polly. Let's throw y'all some scratch out. Oh, I think my husband's already done that. Looks like y'all have got some treats. I see it all over. Oh, and he gave y'all a pumpkin. Okay, well, y'all are fixed up. Fixed up. He's moved the rake, unless y'all have. Y'all start cleaning. Look at those. Babies are getting so big. What are you doing up there? Doing? Look how big those babies are getting. I shouldn't call them babies anymore. They're not babies. Are you getting a little bit more feathers? Your tail is about non-existent. Well, they're all looking at me. Y'all got treats already. Goodness. What are you doing? Camera shy. All right, I'm gonna peep inside the coop and see if I can investigate what they're doing in there. Oh, we got another egg in the corner. Are those your eggs? Is that what you're, are you trying to sit? I don't know what she's doing. Well, she doesn't look broody at the moment, but normally they'll lay like a whole clutch of eggs, and they won't see it while they're laying. I'll just lay them in a pile. Of course, I'll take them, but I'll know if she gets broody. She'll start acting like it. She'll start puffing out and not wanting to go back out into the run with everybody else. So we'll see. It would be super unusual, I think, for a leghorn to do that often. But, hey, stranger things have happened.